and welcome to Team Tuesday on Tuesday this time. It is September the 14th of 2021. We've had a couple of weeks off of Team Tuesday videos because of a live Team Tuesday at the Newton County Library down the street. And then also we had iReady testing last week that kind of took up our afternoon. So here we are, back after a short hiatus. Let's talk about what's going on. First up, midterms Friday? It is. Because our terms are quarters, midterms come fast, and also because time flies when you're having great fun, and we are. We've had really a great start to the school year, and you are in large part responsible for that, so thank you for that. Midterm is a good time. I think it's actually, today's day 14 of the year. Friday will be day 17, and I think there's 37 days in the term, so even Friday won't quite be halfway there, but it is the closest Friday to the middle of the term. So we chose that one. It's a good time to kind of take stock of what we've done so far in the year. There will be a grade report going out for midterm. And those big things that you really need to be thinking about are, well, the ones that ultimately contribute to your graduation, which are earning credits, meaning you gotta be here attendance, and two, you gotta earn those credits. So your grades need to be above a 70 at the alternative school in order to earn those credits. So, now this is a grade report. This is not a permanent record, the report that goes out after this Friday. But it is a good checkpoint to see, oh, how am I doing? I need to either do better. Don't do worse. Don't ever do worse. But anyway, make sure your grades and your attendance are what they need to be here as we approach midterm. This Friday is Constitution Day, and we will be engaging in the Constitution Bowl, which is a competition testing your knowledge of all things U.S. Constitution. Your third block teams will be competing for at least bragging rights. There may be some prizes involved. So we're looking forward to that on Friday. Mr. Oney is in charge of Constitution Day, so we'll get some details from him soon. ASTs are also approaching. After midterm, after school, tutoring becomes mandatory for students who are in one of two categories. One, you're over on attendance, and we've had an attendance contract meeting and arranged times for you to make up days that you've missed. Now, this is a reminder that we make up time in a one-to-one fashion. So one whole school day is four after-school tutoring sessions that are 90 minutes long. So for every class you go over, you will have that exact amount of time after school you need to make up. It's practically useful. It's not terribly fun. Our classes are really what we've put all our energy into designing and arranging during the day to be interactive and thought-provoking and interesting for you. If you've missed those, is why you need to make up time. But you really don't want to be climbing that hill. It's tough actually to make up that much time after school. So don't put yourself in that spot. But it is a safety net if you need it. We will have to meet and arrange those. Things are getting serious. If we have an attendance contract, meaning you went over your 4 days, it is to make clear to you that this is serious, that you are jeopardizing right at that moment your credits. It is not guaranteed to you. We may say, these are not legitimate absences. You've been irresponsible and we are not offering you an attendance contract. In that case, you will just lose your credits for the term. And you can't hang around here on our roster very long if you're not earning your credits. In fact, do that two terms in a row, it's automatic drop. You got to earn your credits to graduate high school. Make sure you're doing that. Also, if you're not passing any given class, if your grade dips below 70 in any class, you are required to be in AST after school. If you are not passing or not within the attendance contract, and then you don't come to AST, we will review your placement here at that moment. That is a safety net, and if you cut off the safety net, it's not safe anymore. Anyhow, that's kind of the progression of how that goes. I don't mean to sound too browbeating today, but it's my job. Counselor request form. We're actually going to leave this little presentation here right now and go over to our Team Tuesday page on Canvas. Right here, this link right here, if you click on that, you can request to meet with a counselor. And if you're experiencing an extremely urgent situation or an emergency, you should speak directly with one of us. This is really more of a... not emergency request. So, you know, the information here is basically asking, you know, just saying, I want to talk to a counselor. And, you know, it may take us just a minute to arrange for that. And then there's kind of an urgency scale. So if it's super urgent, like I'd like to do it today if possible, that's 5. If it can wait, that's 1. And then there's just a little bit, some categories here to categorize. The reason for which you want to talk to a counselor. And then there's also a couple of subsequent questions about if there's someone on staff that you trust, if there's a specific counselor besides Ms. Clements that you'd like to talk to, and then also if there's anyone that you really don't want to talk to. So that will send alerts to Ms. Clements, to us, and notifications anyway to let us know that you've made that request, and then we can arrange it for you. Like I say, Ms. Clements isn't always in the building. She has to be dispatched to a number of other places, and so this will help us kind of arrange for counselor visits. Okay. Phone numbers. There is also on Team Tuesday, right here, a student phone number form. I want everyone to fill this out. So what I need is your phone number. I want to know if you received text at that number, and then any special notes like, oh, I usually have this phone for about a week until my minutes run out, or I share this phone with my brother, or any kind of special stuff down there at the bottom. We're going to start using a JSC building specific portal for the push notification system for the district. So this is really nice if you could be walking on your way to school and, I don't know, a water main breaks and we send out a text that says, hey, we're not going to be able to have class today. You can go home. That will keep me from making 50 phone calls or, you know, whatever it may be. That's a more efficient form of communication. So we want those to go to parents and students. Students, we need your phone number. So that's not like your mom's phone number. That is your personal phone number. I assume that, you know, many of you have those. So there is that. Next on the Team Tuesday page, Matters of the Mind Google Form. As a school during the whole school assemblies, we would like to address issues that are relevant and important to you. As adults, we have identified issues we feel should be addressed, including consent, healthy relationships, legal rights. However, we would like to hear from you. What topics would you like to learn about and explore? And this is really kind of part of our character kickoff series. A lot of character education in schools is geared towards elementary students and isn't terribly relevant to young adults like you. And so we try to kind of customize our character education to be age appropriate. We know that I think it's part of respecting your intelligence as young adults is to, address you like the young adults you are and scale these things up. So there's a lot of things in your life right now that are new and challenging. And we understand that. And so although we can kind of try to remember what it's like to be our age and come up with our own list, we would like to know what kind of issues you face. What are the, you know, real problems in your life that you could use some wisdom about? And so if we don't have it, we'll seek it out. So help us help you by giving us some suggestions there about issues and topics that you'd like to see addressed in our character kickoffs. FAFSA, Federal Application for Student Aid. That's what that stands for. And if you have any inkling of a plan of future education, be it in college or a trade school or whatever it may be, you need to fill out the federal application for student aid. Federal refers to the federal government in Washington, D.C. This is an application, meaning you're applying for. For is the second F. Student aid is like student loans, grants, in any kind of financial aid that you may need in continuing education. This is the starting point. That workshop has like, this is for seniors or anyone who might graduate before. It's kind of confusing, but it's an application for the academic year, which is the next academic year, 22-23. You can still fill out an application for 21-22, so this is especially important for some of you seniors who are looking at a December graduation and maybe a January enrollment at Crowder. I know I've talked to Rudy, Alfredo, Sal, and there may be some more there who are looking at maybe enrollment this academic year, 21-22. And so we will need to actually fill out a couple of applications. The point being, there's a lot of very specific information that might not be terribly intuitive. I've got a guide. We're going to have a pre-FAFSA workshop before this where you get as much progress on that application as possible. And then on 10-20, 21, and 12-15, that's a Wednesday in October, the experts from the TRIO program at Crowder are coming to campus to help us tidy and finish those up. So this will be something of a process, but it could be worth, frankly, tens of thousands of dollars to you. So this is a big one to put on your calendar, seniors or seniors next year. We'll kind of talk about who exactly this might apply to, and I'll let you know. But super, super important. Parents and guardians, like if you would like to attend this meeting to make sure that students have all of the relevant information. There's some, any tax returns from last year. If you have questions about whether or not you are financially, there's a lot of minutia details. So anyhow, this is super important. No, it's coming in October. We just got that scheduled on Friday, so that's new. Okay, quick review of the calendar. Today is Tuesday the 14th. We got a short week this week. A lot going on Friday. Cat time is during fourth block. That's the last block of the day. That'll be a nice way to end it. Constitution Quiz Bowl with details pending from Mr. Oney. And it's midterm. So here we are at midterm already. Can't believe it. But things are going great. Let's keep up our momentum. Have a good Tuesday.